That makes a change from your usual fantasies about semi-naked women in bits of white underwear.
Not really. These sofas already had semi-naked women in them. They squeezed up to let me sit down.
That's your trouble. You're obsessed with sex.
It's your fault you keep on giving me suggestive food. What are you cooking, anyway?
Well, it's basically an adaptation of a Persian dish and a rather subtle juniper sauce, followed by jelly and ice cream.
With hundreds and thousands?
Yeah.
Good. Need something to take my mind off Lisa.
Yeah.
I taught her all my best beer mat tricks, you know. Why did she leave me?
Perhaps she shouldn't have slept with her best friend.
Yeah. Women don't like that much, do they? Her teeth went all kind of clenched, like in Dallas. Is this mine?
Nope.
Good, I'm gonna change.
I'll change it to something useful, like a curry. Hey, I think a woman's gonna move in upstairs. I found a letter addressed to someone called Deborah.
Great, what's it say?
How should I know? It's private. Actually, I did accidentally steam it open and read it. Mother enjoyed a holiday in France, but the weather was a bit disappointing.
France, eh? Bonjour, Deborah. Je m'appelle Dermot, I'm sensitive and artistique.
Have you got the sharp knife in there?
Yeah, it's on the side. I'll bring it out in a minute.
Yo, get down, bitch!
Dermot! Oh, I see, it's a duvet. Well, silly old me, I thought for a minute there you'd spent all the money you owe me on a new suit, you piece of scum.
I'm looking after it for a friend.
No, you're not.
Why, it's an investment.
No, it isn't. It's a bloody new bloody suit, you bastard.
It's not my fault. Whenever I see a cheque, I go out of control. I'm the same with tight black skirts, actually.
This is my money we are talking about here. What would you say if I emptied your wallet and went out on a spending spree?
I'd say, what can you buy these days for an old library ticket and a picture of Lisa bending down on Brighton Beach?
Shut up. Well, what else have you bought for yourself?
Nothing.
Well, what's in that bag?
Oh, it's a cookery book.
You expect me to believe that, do you?
You're always saying you're tired of me cooking the same thing all the time.
Yeah, all right.
Not that there's anything wrong with fish fingers sur la toast.
Take those stupid sunglasses off.
That's something women find hard to believe, isn't it? Two men can have a quiet evening in on their own, enjoying a thoughtful and civilized conversation.
Mm. What were we talking about this morning?
Patsy Kensit's bicycle.
No, no, about you chucking Dorothy.
Oh.
You sure you know what you're doing?
Yeah.
She taught you everything you know.
Like what?
Well, sex. The way I'd heard it, you'd been pressing all the wrong buttons down there for years.
Well, she put me right in a few technical details, yes.
She said it was like sleeping with a badly informed Labrador.
Labrador?
Honestly, the potholes in your road. Lily came off my bike twice. 12-hour shift without so much as a Mars bar between bedpans. Then the lifts go on the blink and I've got a hysterectomy stuck between two floors.
Good evening, Dorothy.
Didn't tell me you were cooking, Gary. Hello, Dermot.
Hello, Dorothy. You're looking well.
Hear that, Gary? A compliment. Remember compliments?
They embarrass me. Anyway, you know you're looking well. You're a nurse.
I thought I'd pay you a spontaneous visit. What have you two been up to?
Oh, you know, discussing life, women, the meaning of it all.
That's what turns me on about you, Gary. You're not just a burglar alarm salesman. You're also fantastically shallow.
If you must know, I was trying to comfort poor Dermot, who's sitting there destroyed for the love of a woman.
It's all right, I'm beginning to pick up the pieces.
And I'd prefer it if you didn't arrive like this, unannounced, and interrupt.
Your brain-dead ideas about women? Yeah, well, I'm gonna go and run myself a bath.
See what I mean? She just barges in.
Well, you gave her the keys.
At least she could let herself out.
I don't see what the problem is. I mean, at least we'll get a clean bath at the end of it.
I'll tell you, mate, it's over. I'm going to start the moody silences.
You started yet? You're going to wait for her to come back?
Shut up.
Thing happened to me at the hospital today. This bloke came in with an aubergine.
Dorothy! Can you pay a bit of attention? I mean, something's wrong here.
Oh, is that what it is?
Look, I'd like my keys back.
You want to finish with me, is that it?
God, that didn't take long.
No. I just think that we both need more time on my own.
Discover myself.
To discover myself. I mean, it's nothing to do with you. It's all me. I'm in a personal space thing, and I need the personal space to discover the person within myself. It's a voyage of discovery-ness. You see what I mean?
I'll leave you two to it.
So, you think we should split up then?
I do if you're unhappy, yes.
Yeah. And you can cope with the idea of being on your own?
Well, hasn't been much fun lately, has it?
Hasn't it?
I sometimes think the only thing that's keeping us together is sex.
Even with a badly informed Labrador, as Dermot informs me.
Sorry, Dorothy.
Just go to your room, will you?
Well, here are your keys.
So this is it?
Seems to be.
And you're okay?
Well, obviously you don't go out with a person for 2 years without...
I know, I'm upset too.
I was gonna say without wanting to try out a few other people.
There's no need to be callous.
No, if you want to finish it, fine. I'll just have to go on with my life. See how things work out with Graham.
With who?
Graham.
Who's Graham?
Oh, friend.
What sort of friend?
Friend. You know, friend.
What, the talking to kind of friend or the taking each other's clothes off kind of friend?
But Gary, I'm not
That's
going
great,
into it.
Isn't it? I mean, you're honest with someone, you make a commitment to them, and then you find out they've got a bloody friend. What's this friend got that I haven't?
Well, he doesn't just sit there adjusting his underwear, he talks to me.
I talk to you?
He's sensitive.
I'm sensitive.
He's a doctor.
I'm sensitive. Look, perhaps I don't need quite so much time to myself. I can't bear the thought of not sleeping with you again.
I know.
I'm a bit confused.
Oh, I know.
Do you love me, Noodle?
I love you, donkey. Hello. Didn't tell me you had a new friend, Dermot.
We haven't known each other long.
Oh, hi, I'm Deborah. I bought the flat upstairs.
Oh, hello, Gary. Flat downstairs.
No.
Oh, this is Dorothy. She's a nurse.
Does anyone know what this is?
Oh, yes, I took the precaution of mobilising your door. Total security, see?
I just touched it and it fell off.
Yeah. Well, the concept still needs some fine-tuning.
It fell onto the bridge of my foot.
Oh, that's awful.
I'm a nurse. If anyone needs any treatment, I'll be giving it.
I'm fine.
Let me put your foot in a sling or something.
Oh, thanks. But I have to go and measure up. I'm moving in tomorrow.
Oh, you can't go measuring up after a serious foot injury. Here, have some wine. Cheers.
So, will you be living in a sharing situation?